Hello everyone, 你好。This is Miss Huang, 我是黄老师。Welcome to the Flipped Classroom for Integrated Chinese, Lesson 8, Part 1, Level 1, Part 1. Today we are going to learn Lesson 8, The School Life. 今天我们学第八课，学校生活。In this lesson, you will learn to use Chinese to describe the routine of a student's life on campus, write a simple diary entry, write a brief letter in the proper format, express your modesty in terms of your foreign language ability, invite friends to go on an outing. Before we go to the test, let's go over the vocabulary first.Please repeat after me. 篇篇日记日记累累起床起床床床 Let's talk about these four words. So number one is 篇篇 is a measure word for essays and articles. It is also the measure word for the diary. So if you want to say one diary, you do not say 一日记. Instead, you will say 一篇日记. Two diaries will be 两篇日记. Number three, 累, 累, 累 means tired, very tired, 很累, not tired.不累。If you want to form a sentence like I am very tired, in Chinese, it is 我很累。我很累。Remember when, because 累 is an adjective, when it is used as a predicate, in Chinese, the pattern, it will be degree adverbials plus adjectives plus subjects.There will not be any to be 是 in between. You do not say 我是很累 You say 我很累 I am not tired. In Chinese will be 我不累 How to say today I am very tired? 今天我很累 Today I very tired. 今天我很累 Today I am not tired will be今天我不累。Number four, 起床 get up. If you want to add time to the time when you get up, that will, for example, it is 9 a.m. That will be 早上九点起床。You have to put the time in front of the verbs. 早上九点 9 o'clock.In the morning, 9 a.m. 起床 get up. Number five, 洗澡 If you want to say take a bath at 9 p.m., that will be 晚上九点洗澡 Still, the time should be put in front of the verb 早上九点洗澡 Take a bath at 9 p.m. 早饭 breakfast.Eat breakfast, 吃早饭 Eat breakfast, 吃早饭一边 is an adverbial. It indicated the simultaneity between two actions. We will talk this in the grammar. 教室 classroom. Oh, I forgot two words. Because we have breakfast here, I also want you to learn how to say lunch. Lunch will be 午饭, 午饭. Dinner will be 晚饭, 晚饭. Because 午, this word is also, does also mean lunch. 晚 means dinner or night. 教室, classroom. In the classroom, 在教室.In Chinese classroom, 在中文教室。In Miss Huang's Chinese classroom, 在黄老师的中文教室。 Alright, that's the word, new words for the first part. And then let's talk about the grammar. The first grammar is the position of time when expressions. Time when expressions are always used as adverbials. They come before the verb. They often appear after the subject. So the sequence will be subject plus time when expressions and plus verb. However, they sometimes precede the subjects under certain discourse conditions. Usually when we want to emphasize the time, we'll put those time when expressions in front of the sentence. In this lesson, we focus on practicing the one positioned after the subject. Let's see the examples. 我们十点上课。上课 start the class. 十点 this is a time when expressions. It is put in between the subject and verb, which is used as a predicate in the sentence. 我们几点去几点 what time 去 go 我们 we what time are we going 几点 is a time when expressions. Example 3. 你什么时候睡觉你什么时候睡觉睡觉 go to bed 什么时候 what time 你 you what time do you go to bed什么时候 is a time when expressions. Actually, it is a time when question phrase. 他明天上午八点来。明天上午八点。Tomorrow, 8 a.m. 来 come. 他 he will come at 8 tomorrow morning.明天上午八点 will be the time when expressions. It is put right in between the subject and the come, the verb. Alright, let's see. There is a post. This post, this sign outside is put outside the student cafeteria. What is the sign for? Can you answer the following questions after reading the sign?So let's read the sign first. 开饭时间开饭开饭开 start, fine, food, 时间 time, or schedule. 早 morning, 午 lunch, 晚 night, 周末 weekend. 早七点半九点早七点到八点五十一点到一点晚五点到六点半周末早七点半到九点半 I think you absolutely can understand the meaning of this sign, but how to put that into Chinese and how to answer those questions? So let's see the questions first. 学生什么时候吃早饭？什么时候吃午饭？什么时候吃晚饭？学生，什么时候吃早饭？什么时候吃午饭？什么时候吃晚饭？ Do you understand these questions? When, what time will the students have breakfast? What time to have lunch?What time to have dinner? Because the last two sentences share the same subjects with the first question, so the subjects has been omitted for the second and third question. Alright, let's answer. 学生早上七点到八点吃早饭。中午十一点到一点吃午饭，晚上五点到六点半吃午饭。Do you understand those questions? Do you understand those answers? If you do not, please go to the, please ask your teacher next morning. Grammar 2, the adverb 就。 2. Because we learned due before in lesson 7, so if you do not, so if it's the first time for you to know due, you have to go back to lesson 7 and go over this grammar 3. The adverb due, connecting two verbs or verb phrases, indicating that the second action happens as soon as the first one is completed. Example 1. 他今天早上起床以后就听中文录音了。起床 is the first verb, get up. 听中文录音。Listen to the Chinese recordings, the second verb phrase. 就 is put in between the first verb phrase and the second verb phrase and indicating that the second action to listen to the Chinese recordings happens as soon as the first action to get up is completed. After he got up, he soon will listen to the Chinese recordings. He listened to the Chinese recordings right after he got up this morning. Okay, right, 就 has the same meaning as right. 王鹏写了信以后就去睡觉了。写了信 wrote the letter, 去睡觉 go to bed. 就 put in between those two verb phrases means right after, right, okay.Wang Peng went to bed right after he had finished writing the letter. Grammar 3, 一边一边。一边一边 is a structure. This structure denotes the simultaneity of two ongoing actions. In general, the word or phrase for the action that started earlier follows the first 一边。While that for the action that started later follows the second 一边。Example 1. 我们一边吃饭一边练习说中文。吃饭 to eat food. 练习说中文 to practice speaking Chinese. 一边 simultaneously, 一边一边一边precedes both of these two word verbs indicating those two actions happens at the same time. We practice speaking Chinese while having dinner. 他常常一边吃饭一边看电视。He often eats and watches TV at the same time. They often had food while watching TV.Centrally, the verb that follows the first 一边 indicates the principal action for the moment, while the verb 1 that follows the second 一边 denotes an accompanying action. 我一边洗澡一边唱歌。So, 洗澡 is a verb. 唱歌 is a second verb after the second 一边. 洗澡 will be the main verb. 洗澡 take a bath.唱歌 sing a song. I sang while having a shower. 我妹妹喜欢一边看书一边听音乐。看书 reading books, 听音乐 listening to music. My younger sister loves listening to music while she reads. So 看书 will be the main principal actions for the moment, while 听音乐will denote an accompanying action. Alright, let's go over this test, this dialogue. Number 1, please read after me. 李友的一篇日记11月3日星期二今天我很忙很累早上7点半起床洗了澡以后就吃早饭。我一边吃饭一边听录音。九点到教室去上课。Alright, let's talk about the details of this dialogue. So, 李友 is a name. 的 is a possessional particle. 李友 the noun or pronoun plus 的 means somebody's. 偏 is a new word for today. 偏 is a measure word for diary. 日记 diary. 李友的一篇日记 Leo's one diary. One of the Leo's diary. 十一月月 means month. 日 means date. 日 is used in written Chinese. For speaking Chinese, you will use how. So when you speak the date,You will say 十一月三号 instead of 十一月三日 because 日 is for the written Chinese. 星期 week, 二星期二 Tuesday. Let's review the names for each day of the week. So Monday, 星期一 Tuesday, 星期二 Then, 星期三星期四星期五星期六星期天今天 today 我很忙很 the degree adverbial 很忙 busy adjective when adjective used as a predicate you do not use 是 or to be in front in this sentence you just say subjects plus the degree adverbial and plus adjective我很忙 I very busy. I am very busy. 很累 very tired. 累 is a new word for this dialogue, means tired. 早上 morning, 七点半 7:30, 起床 so 早上七点半 means 7:30 a.m. So a.m. in English is put after the time, but in Chinese, we use 早上and put it in front of the time. 起床 get up. I get up at 7:30 a.m. 洗了澡 took bath. 以后 after. So in English you say after I took the bath, but in Chinese after 以后 is used after the verb, following the verb.So you say verb phrase, so you say 洗了澡以后就 indicate the second action happens very soon. 吃 eat 早饭 breakfast. To eat breakfast. 我一边一边 is a grammar, is a structure, 一边一边一边一边 guide two actions. The first action will be 吃饭The second action will be 听 listen, 录音 recordings. 九点 time, 到教室教室 classroom, 去上课。到 indicate the location, 去 indicate the action. So this is also a structure, means go to some places to do something. Go to the classroom to start the class, to take the class. The opposite for 上课 is 下课。下课 means class is over. Alright, let's go. Let's read this dialogue one more time. Please repeat after me or read with me. 李友的一篇日记十一月三日星期二今天我很忙很累早上七点半起床洗了澡以后就吃早饭我一边吃饭一边听录音九点到教室去上课